attached to in his work. And the Srimad Bhagavatam is given so many examples of this. We are attached to the opposite sex, the opposite gender, and we are attached to family life, and we are attached to this and that. So this attachment is not conducive for spiritual life. At the same time, it is not something wrong with having a family and children like that. I think it was Bhaktivinoda Thakur who said that as a grihastha one has to learn affection without being attached. So this is, you know, we should show affection to all living entities. So as a devotee we can have affection for our family members. But at the same time we can be detached. So this is a beginner or for it may be difficult to understand, but it is completely possible. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he showed by his own example that he had many children and took care of them very nicely, took care of the family. He was completely on Paramahamsa platform. So there are so many attachments that we have in this world, and we have to get rid of this attachment. And usually the wrong kind of attachment, that means that we have some selfish interest. We have some selfish interest in this sense object, so to say. But if you see everything in relation to Krishna, yes, it's possible to feel affection for all living entities like that. So we have to be free from attachment and aversion also. We don't like different things in this world. Sometimes we don't like the chemistry between people, that some or other two persons cannot go together, but there is chemistry which is not doesn't work. So one has to be also detached from his aversions in spiritual life. And sometimes you're put in Krishna is putting you in a situation where you have difficulties with somebody and you cannot get rid of the problem. So this is also a purification. We have to, sometimes we have to get purified by having some clash or something with somebody like that. So if we take it as a purification, then we will make it. And usually these kind of situations, they are not eternal. They are temporary. Whatever suffering we are in, we should know that this suffering will go over at one point. Of course, some people, they are suffering for a long time, but it's never eternal. And especially for the devotee, Krishna is arranging so that we become purified, and from something, sometimes we have to suffer a little from something, but then that is dissolved. So we have to become detached like that from our attachments and aversion in this world, and then we can take up chanting more purely. enthusiasts chant the names, even if we don't have taste. There are different reasons why we don't have taste for the names. According to the acharyas, the first reason is that we have something that is called tattva vibrahma-tattva. That we don't understand our position. That is also why if we don't understand that we are just a humble little spark of spiritual energy, Krishna's energy, we are belonging to the spiritual energy, and we are a very small, minute part of that the spark. And if we don't understand that we are very, very insignificant in the real sense, then we will not have taste. Something very important, or that we are this and that, then the taste is gone. So the Brahma Tattva, and also Asat Krishna, that we are thirsty for material things, we want sense gratification. If we desire that, then we cannot relish the holy name. And also Rivya Dharmanya, weakness of the heart, that we are accustomed to criticize others, and we are envious maybe of others, and that we have these feelings in the heart, and we are criticizing others. This is also destroying pure devotional service, and we cannot have taste for the whole thing. And also directly making offenses will also destroy the taste for chanting the holy name. So one has to diligently also become aware of offenses, not only, but there are 10 offenses against the chanting of the holy name, and they all come from not actually being attentive to the chanting of the holy name. So then we can have this taste for which we are all conscious. This is not only words, it is actually like that, that there is no limit to the sweet taste of the chanting or the whole name if we are just becoming pure.
Most points in the lecture, but I was just thinking that you have been in the, now in the movement for so many years and never left, and like 35 years, or it's long time, and with family and everything in Anvi. And what is like what is the main reason or the substance like that that have kept you so steady, and to give some maybe advice. There must have been some taste, some for some specific things in Krishna consciousness that have.
There is only one thing, not thing, but it's only Krishna. The only there is taste in serving Krishna, and Anandamaya Vyasat, the living entity, is pleasure seeking. So there is no other superior taste than serving Krishna. for the Vinyasa. So we are all looking for the highest enjoyment. And there is no other enjoyment actually. So, and all the other things comes with that. Like I said in the class there now that I have practical experience of really being in the modes all of my time. So one has to have faith that it's just like going down. Like this example of a person who is punished on a boat, on a ship. In previous times, they took this, I don't know what you call it in English, Sherman in Swedish. Have a rope from one side of the ship to the other, and then they bind the person in that rope, and then he has another rope, and then they push him down, and then they drag him from one to the other side, so that he has to go on with the ship. And when he comes up, he takes some breath, and then they push it from the other side again. It's really like very heavy punishment. He almost drowns. This is, I think this example is given in the teachings of Lord Chaitanya. Being under the most material nature is sometimes like that. That we are like heavily punished. But even if we think that it's very, very heavy at one point, then one has to have faith that actually the process will work. And I don't know if I answered your question.
Krishna's mercy.
First, there's taste in the chanting the holy name, because it's not different from Krishna. And we have to have the mercy of the Supreme Lord. And he's the pure devotees. Without the grace of the Spirit and also I cannot make any advancement.
But are the tests getting worse and worse?
No. I don't experience that. The worst was in the beginning.
Yes. I was wondering because there seems to be so many things like said by the Acharyas and also Srila Prabhupada which aren't really stated in Bhagavad Gita, but still Prabhupada says that one doesn't need anything else than Bhagavad Gita. How is that?
Yeah, because that's the nature of Krishna's words. They are complete, full. In one sense, there is no need for anything else than the holy name. And we also see that this is happened with Rosatan came to this Brahmana, who got the instruction from his spiritual master to read Bhagavad Gita, and then he cannot read. He's sometimes having it upside down, but he's crying. And Rosatan is asking, why are you crying? Because I see in the picture here that Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is driving the chariot of Arjuna, because he like his friend. So they have this very intimate relationship. So then he thinks that Krishna is so kind and so merciful that he is crying. He sees some of Krishna's qualities, and Lord Chaitanya says that you have attained perfection because you have really understood Bhagavad Gita. So he has understood. Actually, if somebody would read Bhagavad Gita, he would understand everything. It's also the same thing with if we realize Krishna, then the Shastra will be how is that? Yasya Deva Parabhakti. Yasya Only after those who have kissed the impious face in the spirit of Master and Krishna are all equal for the daily pleasure. So if we have complete faith in the spirit of Master and Krishna, then when this Brahmana has complete faith, then he understood everything. But this does not also minimize what the Acharyas are saying. They are giving same message and explaining in more elaborately and like that. There's a series of verses in the first canto. Hearing Srimad Bhagavatam and like rendering devotional service to the pure devotees, the lower modes of the material nature can go away from the practitioner, and he comes to the world of goodness, and he's happy in the world of goodness. And then when he makes further advancement, he can realize the science of God. Eva Prasanna Manasu, Bhagavad Bhakti Yoga. He understands the science of Krishna consciousness, God completely. Because it is revealed in the heart to that devotee. Are you satisfied with that answer?
I remember the point where you said they elaborate further, but they keep the same message.
Yeah.
So, I suppose. Not quite, but it's a little hint.
Also in this book, what is the difficulty? There is one story that Prabhupada, or at least he told it when he was in Alnwick, Prabhupada was reading Bhagavad Gita, and he was smiling and laughing to himself. This book is enough for God to go. And then, who's the author of that book? Shutakirti Prabhu, yeah. He said that, he has said that about Chaitanya Charitamrita, and he said it also about Bhagavad Gita. So he said, this is enough. This is enough for going back to London. So we have the word of Prabhupada also.
You gave a perfect answer.
Pardon?
You gave a perfect answer.
Like this with the example of Prabhupada.
Yes, what you said is perfect. Nothing is missing.
Okay.
If one understands this or not, that's a different story. I was wondering, in the nectar of devotion, it is said that we should not circumambulate in front of the deities, but sometimes during the kirtan we dance together, the devotees dance, Lord Chaitanya would also dance with his devotees. But why is that that you should not circumambulate, because sometimes we are dancing around in a circle and some devotees don't want to take part in that because they have read that you should not circumambulate in front of the deities.
Yeah, I have not a good answer. I remember that this question was asked before, and it was just that I can't remember the answer. Maybe somebody else. So you have this discussion here.
Which
one? Somebody, some person, they think that, yeah, probably.
Well, just a comment that circumambulating, so somebody's in the center, right? You're circumambulating something.
Okay.
Isn't that correct understanding of the, just the word itself, circumambulate?
Yeah, that would be
what picture they get in your head, because when I hear that, I'm thinking like Well, the planets are circumnavigating Mount Meru, but that means the Mount Meru is in the center. So something has to be in the center in order for somebody to circumnavigate it. So that means that we close the altar when we do Tusi Puja, because we circumnavigate Tusi, because he's in the center.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's a circle of dancing, it's almost in the center, nobody's being circumnavigated in that sense. That would be maybe one point.
Makes sense. Also, I mean, I have experienced so many kirtans, ecstatic kirtans, where we are, you know, dancing like this round. So if that would be offensive, I don't think the ecstasy would manifest. If it would be like disturbing for the deities.
We also saw some movie footage with Prabhupada, one of the first Harinams in a park. And he mentioned that like the mood of Prabhupada was when, to begin with, the people participating, they were very much like self-centered and just trying to absorb themselves and speculate about the holy name. And Prabhupada was like tolerating and playing and changing. But once they started dancing together and dancing in a circle, Prabhupada, he lightened up quite a lot because he saw that they joined them together.
Yeah.
Which is like more in line with the spiritual nature of the soul to interact.
Yeah. I have the feeling that when the groups are dancing together, it becomes like it lifts off. It's a congregational chanting. As when the Buddha just started dancing together, like then it's very nice.
Yeah, once more, because we did have a discussion about whether we'd be proper to. For Govardhan, yeah, so soon have Govardhan Puja. So whether it would be proper to, because we have normally a mountain of halwa, and then we put the Govardhan Shiva on top of the mountain of halwa. And then usually a circumambulation. Well, that could be done like simultaneous with Goa Arati. That discussion was there. I don't know if you had any comments.
Usually we have some deity of Krishna on top of Govardhan, isn't it?
We take a Govardhan Shiva and usually take
it. Yeah. So then I don't think there's any problem with that.
I was also thinking you're circumambulating Krishna, so there should
yeah.
be there shouldn't be a problem there. That's my comment.
Thank you. Group.